In order to improve salmon rearing habitat in the Upper Dungeness watershed, the Forest Service partnered with the Jamestown S'Klallam Tribe and others to complete the Dungeness Large Woody Debris Project in October of 2016.
I'm Kurt Grinnell. I'm with the Jamestown S'Klallam Tribe, and we are salmon people. The S'Klallam people lived along these shores for centuries. There was an old saying that when the tide is out, the table is set. We were known to be a rich tribe, not in the way people think about it today, but we had food, and when people back then had access to food, they thrived. When it comes to modern days, as these river systems are in such jeopardy, not only the Jamestown Tribe, but other tribes in Washington State and other states, are working diligently to try to bring these systems back from disrepair. They're in a lot of trouble. We can't do it by ourselves, and that's why we partner with like-minded people. This takes time, it takes a lot of money, it takes a lot of planning, it takes really good people to finish these projects, but once done, it really helps those salmon get up there and stay where they're capable of staying without washing out. Partnering with the Forest Service and other community partners, you start thinking with one mind you can actually get something done in the rivers and in the systems that we have around here.
The Forest Service is directed by our management plan, which is the Northwest Forest Plan, to restore and maintain aquatic systems. And the Dungeness Large Wood Project that the Forest Service partnered with the Jamestown S'Klallam Tribe is getting to that restore component of that management plan. We've been involved in restoration activities within the Dungeness for decades, historically focused in on road decommissioning in the upper watershed. We've partnered with other organizations, the S'Klallam Conservation District, in taking off roads that were in the riparian area and on unstable landforms that were delivering sediment to listed fish habitat. Dungeness Large Wood Project was first envisioned through, I guess, walking the river with the tribal biologist when we were actually GPSing Chinook reds. Through that process, it was obvious that spawning gravels in both the Dungeness and the gray wolf were in short supply, or they were a limiting factor within the river. Where we found spawning gravels were associated with large wood, natural jams that were collecting the size of substrate that salmon can use to create reds. The idea was to focus in on reaches of the river that are low gradient and have a wide floodplain, and where you would expect to see side channels. We surveyed the entire anadromous reach, or the salmon steelhead reaches, of the Dungeness and Gray Wolf, and prioritized reaches where we felt we can do the most good to improve spawning and rearing habitat for salmon and steelhead.
We're out here this morning on the Gray Wolf River, which is a tributary to the Dungeness, the home watershed of the Jamestown S'Klallam people. But building structures out of logs with root wads and then using an anchoring system to hold them in place, we're hoping that the jams will mimic how the river would naturally create these jams with logs and rocks that tumble downstream during high flows. The log jams are designed to slow the water's velocity and allow for fine sediment and gravel to settle out, which will create better salmon habitat that they need for building their nests and laying their eggs. The tribe and the Forest Service began planning for this project all the way back in 2013. It was funded through the local Salmon Recovery Funding Board lead entity group in 2014, but we decided to hold off constructing the project for a year. That would be the year 2015 season, because that is an odd year, and the main salmon species that utilize this section of the river are pink salmon, and they return on odd years. So we wanted to avoid overlapping construction during a pink run year. So we waited till summer of 2016 to begin construction of this project. And believe me, we needed all the time for planning and generating all the materials, staging everything at key locations, organizing everything for the helicopter transport. It was a lot of upfront work for this project. Ironically, we were able to build the project in just over 2 days. 16 hours is all it took us to complete the project from start to finish of the construction phase, but you can imagine there were several years prior of planning and organizing to get everything to this one final moment.
That's one of the best things we could do for the imperiled stocks, of three of which are on the endangered species list. Any restoration projects we do try to enhance the available habitat for them to adjust to the current conditions in the river, which, as you said, are steep and fast. And so providing them places to get out of the flood flow.
At high flows.
At high flows, like they used to have, these relic side channels. That's why we built the jams where we did, is to encourage the river to reactivate these side channels at lower flow conditions than they are right now. They're only active during super high floods.
Yeah.
So we'd like more water to be in these more times of the year.
Year round.
For us, collaboration is the key. We have found that it's just a lot easier to accomplish our goals when we form effective partnerships with an agency, city or a county, or a local landowner. Forming those partnerships and those relationships is key to our restoration goals.
Success to the Indian people, we don't look at it, our success, overnight or over a week or a month period. We look at it over decades. If you look at how long we've been working on the Dungeness alone, I've been watching it for 35 years myself. We have to raise a lot of money, we have to work with a lot of good people, and we have to have a lot of patience. But we're in better shape now than we were a few years ago. And if we keep up our good pace and our good work, we feel that we can bring things back around for our future generations. And it's not just for the Indian people, it's for all people.